So many times, I mean, look at all these people. I'm here to ask them for money. I'm not taking their money. And I'm looking over here, and I'm like, you would have told me 8 years ago I'd be over here with the pawpaw. I would have told you, whatever you're smoking, I want some. But, you know, like my shirt said, you know, I got a lot of issues, and I don't mean both. You feel me? I'm going to keep it short and simple. Look. You know, damn. Miss Shirley, I'm kidding.
You can do it, Robin. Come on.
Come on, Robin.
So, I had so many issues that my issues led me to stealing, smoking, robbing. You had it, I'ma take it. Whatever. Homeless. That's what my issues led me. Alright, hey, let y'all know.
Can we turn the volume up? Volume.
Well, you want me to shout some more? Yeah.
Speak up, Robin.
Come on, Robin.
Yeah.
Well, you got no problem yelling at me, buddy.
Get off my chest.
Get off
my chest. I mean, real talk. I'm grateful. I'm blessed to be here today with the help of God. For me, street life saved my life, because I wouldn't be here right now. And that's the God's honest truth. I'd be in the penitentiary because I would have done shot somebody. For real, real. You know, I grew up in East Palo Alto. I ran the streets from San Francisco all the way to San Jose. I come from a big gang-affiliated family, and I also come from a family full of cops. So I was that educated hood rat that rode on the little bridge like this, and I know which way to go, which way not to go. And I wiggled like nobody else could wiggle, boy, I'll tell you what. I was in and out of my wire like, now you're going north. That's real talk. And then I met Miss Shirley. Woo-wee. I'm going to tell you what. You got to come to my program, Robin. I said, no, I don't. I'm not going to start this. You got no free behavior. So, needless to say, I ended up at Shirley's house. Yes, indeed. And then she sent me to Pastor Dave. And she said, I want to go around the corner and go to that church over there. I said, why? She said, girl, just get your ass up and go. So I go over there, and I'm like, I see all the homies outside. I'm like, wow, he's looking so happy. What's up with that? And then I see Pastor Dave. Hi, my name is Dave Sherrod. I was like, this is me with that. And move it, you know? And I was like that for the first year. You know, my behaviors, my attitude, you know, I was like, you can't tell me nothing. Popo can't tell me nothing. Nobody can tell me nothing. Only Robin can tell Robin. You know what I'm saying? It don't work like that, you know? I'm gonna let y'all know. They say it takes a whole village to raise a child, right? Well, it takes a whole team of people to take one of me and help her become me now. What it was like for me was I found God, you know? I didn't believe in God. God wouldn't do nothing for me. God wouldn't pay my bills or help me, you know, if I can get my dope for me. Y'all wouldn't do none of that. Robin was doing that. But then these things happened to me. And one of them things was I got hit by a car when I was in my recovery. And you know, and when you're in recovery, you got one person over here and the other one over here. And you think, I'm on my bicycle, and I couldn't even ride a bicycle. And I'm like, on my way to church, okay? On my way to church, I'm about, like, I say my third year of sobriety, you know what I'm saying? And I'm at the stoplight, my turn to go, I get on my bicycle, I look, and I see this car, and the car hit me. Because in my mind, as I was going across, I was like, oh, if I go over here to the Trump house, nobody's gonna know. Pastor David, Jerry and I, you know, Kevin and Vicky are there. I'll be up front. Nobody's gonna say no. Nobody's gonna know. God knew. He couldn't just tell. me on the shoulder. He had to have me hit by a car. And then, that's what I heard. When people tell you they heard God talking to them, I used to say, well, they spelled it something real good. God does talk to you, because when I got hit by that car, I live on Jefferson and Alameda. Feel me? That four-way stoplight, people racing up and down the street, y'all need to put some... car hit me, and I flew from one side to the other side. I wouldn't do that. And when the car hit me, I was thinking about going to that crab house, and like, nobody's gonna know. And that car hit me, and I flew all the way to the other side of the intersection. What are you doing? Look, he chased me all the time.